and I'll sing you a song. I'll sing it so softly it'll do no one wrong. On Birmingham Sunday the blood ran like wine, and the choir kept singing our freedom. That cold autumn morning, no eyes saw the sun, and Nannie Mae Collins, her number was one. In an old Baptist church there was no need to run, and the choir kept singing of freedom. The clouds, they were dark, and the autumn wind blew, and Dennis McNair brought the number to two. The falcon of death was a creature they knew, and the choir kept singing of freedom.
When we were colored, I remember when we were colored. Proud I was of this African American stare me in the face. 'Cause see, no one could tell me that even if this dark skin could travel many seas, I couldn't sniff a whiff of this American dream. My skin tone a mere distraction, sat tall with the primitive action of self-pity and lost hope. Back then, when none of these psychotic nurses could tell us that we were only colored because of the curses. And this is not just my story, it's history. When we were colored, and our minds were locked down, enslaved with some of the heaviest chains of emancipation, but as a group of students who look like me, about the father of many nations, and I guarantee you zero participation. 'Cause we were colored. And when you're colored, the truth is blinded by reflections. Visions of spiritual malnutrition and pretend faiths that we are afraid to admit still exist in us. Because the truth of the matter is that many of us are still colored. And I have to say it has nothing to do with color, but shades of old men and women rearing ugly heads from the grave once more to remind us of our worldly twins who refuse to stay drowned. However, the secret lies in the depths of men's hearts. For these old men rise up because of our thirst to keep them there. In the past, when we were taught to rever Satan's forefathers instead of our own tribes, when we were toddlers, back in the day, when we were colored, and that's the peace.
And the choir kept singing of freedom.